Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to create an effect something like this. You can see we have what appears to be spider web covered in dew that is just rattling around a little bit in the wind. It's actually pretty straightforward and we're going to use geometry nodes. So let's make a start. To begin with, you're going to need an image file, which is your spider web. Now you can draw that yourself or you can process an image. I did the latter. And then just to make things quick, I'm just going to import that as an image. I'm just going to add an image as a plane because that will just unwrap it as well all at the same time, which is just what we want. So I've got a file here called spiderweb. And if we have a look at that, we can see that's what it is. So all it is a photograph of a spiderweb against a dark background that I just processed a bit to increase the contrast. But you could just as easily draw one yourself. And that's our starting point. This plane will actually disappear at some point. Now, before we go any further, because I want this to actually be able to be animated, if you don't want to animate it, it doesn't matter so much. I'm going to add some subdivisions. So I'm going to edit mode, right click and subdivide. And we'll just increase the subdivisions here. And let's try 25. That's probably fine. You don't have to go too mad, but you want a reasonable number for the simulations to work. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select, first of all, holding the shift key down, the corners, and then I'm going to select vertices that are somewhere near where at least some of the spider web intersects with the edge. The idea is that when we add a cloth simulation to this, it's going to be as if the web is suspended by these vertices. Perhaps we'll have that one there as well. We'll now come down to here and we'll add a vertex group and assign it. So if I select that, you can see it's just got those selected. Next, I'm just going to add a mesh, which is an icosphere. That's probably enough subdivisions because this is going to be quite small, but we'll set it to shade smooth. If you're going to have a close up on some of the droplets, you may want to use more subdivisions than this, but bear in mind there are going to be a lot of these. There is a little cheat that we can do. So let's just move that over there, make it a bit smaller just to get it out of the way. And remember to apply the scale. We'll open a new window. And we'll go to the shader editor and we'll say new and we'll call that drop or a dew drop. We'll get rid of the principal shader. We don't need anything so complicated. And we'll just add a glass shader, drop that into the surface and set the index of refraction to 1.33, which is the IOR of water. Make sure the color is fully white and that's all we need to do to that. Now we'll go back to our web. You can see we've got this material on there at the moment. And we'll change this to the geometry node editor and we'll say new and we'll start adding some geometry nodes. So I'm going to add a point distribute node first of all, and you can see the mesh has vanished and we've got a couple of points just appeared there. And if I increase the density, you can see the number of points increases. Now I ended up with a quite high number, but we'll just leave it at 10 for the moment. And then I'm going to add a point scale node. We're going to be turning that down quite a long way in a minute. And finally, I'm going to add a point instance node. Make sure it's set to object and we'll select our icosphere. So now let's set the scale down a little bit. And I actually went to a very small scale, but we'll go down to 0.1 at the moment. So you can see them there. But obviously I'll increase the density to 100 now. They're not following the spider web at all at the moment. That will even go to 1000. So they're just covering randomly the mesh. So we need another node to make it understand where to put droplets. So I'm now going to add an attribute sample texture node. Now there's a slight bug with these. In theory, it shouldn't really matter where any of these nodes are as long as they're in the right sequence of nodes. But in actual fact, this node only works if it is the second node after a point distribute node. So just bear that in mind at the moment. Perhaps they'll fix that in the next one. So drop that in there and then click new. And you notice it just creates a texture. We'll click the little button here and that opens a window over here. And we can now go and, because we've already opened it, we can add in our image here by just clicking there and selecting spiderweb. I set the mapping to UV map. It may not matter too much. And then under result, which you can type in here or type in down here, put in scale in all in lowercase. And what this is doing is it's changing the size of our particles depending on whether there is some spiderweb information there. Now, if we start to increase the number of particles, so let's go for 5,000, you can now start to see we've got a spiderweb there. Now, we may need to adjust contrast and things like that a little bit. I turned off alpha because I don't need it. And the mapping, I set that to clip. Shouldn't really make any difference because it'll be sized to the whole image. For my particular image, under colors, I set the brightness to 2. You notice a lot more particles have just appeared. I set the contrast to 3.4, and then you can just adjust the brightness a little bit because that will also affect the size of the particles. So I'm now going to turn the size of the particles down a bit more, halved it, and turn the number of the particles up. So we'll go for 10,000 now. We can even go higher than that. We can put a multiplier on this, and we'll drop the size again. And you can start to see we're getting the effect now if I turn that off. So I'm going to just add a background now. Set this to world. I'm going to add an environment texture, which is an HDRI. And I think I use something like this one. You need to use pretty good lighting if you're trying to illuminate things like this, which are very clear and so on. I'm currently in cycles, by the way. I did this in Eevee. I'm just off-axising the camera slightly so that it's not completely face-on web. Otherwise, it's difficult to see movement. And then we'll go to the camera, switch on depth of field. At this point, I'm going to change to EV so that things are a bit quicker and make sure we've got screen space reflections turned on. Back to the camera, and we'll just say spiderweb for our focus point. So I set the f-stop to 0.7, and now we've got a nice blurry background that's also providing illumination, and we've got our spiderweb. You can add additional lights into the scene if you want to get more bright highlights and things like that. And we can even increase the strength of the background, of course. I'm going to actually reduce the tightness of that depth of field slightly so we've got a bit more of the web in focus. But you can see there's our nice water droplets. Obviously, the web itself is invisible because it's not there. You could add an image with an alpha just to add the fine details. But what I did was relied on the smallest droplets for that. So if we go back to Geometry Node Editor, make those droplets even smaller, gone rather large there, and add a lot more of them. So there's now 100,000 of them. They've highlighted the web very well. But obviously, because most of them are so small, not really getting that idea of a dew-encrusted web. Perhaps we can go slightly bigger than that. So what I did was actually have another set of geometry nodes. So I'm going to take all of these, Shift D, and put them there. But before I connect them, I'm just going to drop the density down to something like 200, but put the size, let's try 0.03. The exact size will vary depending on the size of your model. We'll then connect that into the geometry, and we need to add one more node in order to be able to have multiple nodes feeding in. Under geometry, a join geometry node. So we'll drop that there, and then we'll connect it there. And what that's doing is just giving us a few bigger droplets. I'm going to make them even bigger than that. Let's try 0.1. It's maybe a little bit too big, so 0.075 maybe. And perhaps we can go for a few more. And you can see how that starts to sell the idea of it being a dew on a web. I think I'm even going to increase this one slightly. So that's our web created. And if you just want a still image, that's pretty much it. But what I also wanted to do was to animate it. So that's pretty straightforward. Let's go to here and let's just turn off the visibility of our geometry nodes for a bit. Just because, especially when you've got a lot of particles, that can be a little difficult for the viewport to keep up with. So now under modifiers, we'll click add modifier. So now we'll go to physics properties with our web mesh selected and click cloth. If I press play now, it'll just fall. So scan down and under shape, select our group, pin it. Now if I press play, you can see it basically doesn't move. And that's because it's pinned all the way around. And then come back up to the top and under stiffness, I dropped tension quite a lot. So let's drop that down to 2. I set compression to 3. And you'll need to experiment with different values. There are some presets that you can select that you can try, but you still won't see very much. You can see there's a slight sag, which is good. We want a little bit of movement. The next thing I did was to add a force, which was a wind force, something like that. It doesn't have to be physically that big. And I had to set the strength very high. You can see it's had a slight effect, slightly distorting the shape there. I'm going to go to my camera and turn off depth of field for a while. So go back to the beginning, you can see it's just dipped in slightly. So I set the flow up relatively high and I set the noise amount to maximum as well. But it didn't seem to give me the variation that I needed. And you can see when I first put the strength up, it rattles around a bit, but then it just stays there. I'm not entirely sure why it may be to do with the way this works. So what I ended up doing is putting a very high force on there. The exact amount will vary depending on your particular model. Then move the force around a little bit. So you can do it in all sorts of different ways. Let's just put it in a few different places and just make the force change quite suddenly, either higher or lower. And that will change the tension on there, which will make it rattle around a bit like a real web does. And then I'm marking it again with I, and then fairly quickly I'm going to drop it to 1000 in this case. So we've got all of that band is at 1000, that's at 10,000, that's at whatever it was to begin with, and then we'll perhaps go at 25,000. So let's see what that looks like. And what I did was actually control this with a function. So rather than just doing it manually like that, and as I say, it does depend on what you're trying to do. If we go to the dope sheet, I'll just quickly delete all bar the first keyframe. You can of course move the direction of the wind around as well. That's another way of animating it. But if I go to the graph editor now, make sure that strength setting is selected. Press N to bring up the options on the right and go to modifiers. We'll add a built-in function which will default to sine. I had that, we'll just start with what I used, which was 5.2 for the multiplier, so that slows it down quite a lot. So that's now just turning the wind strength up and down, as you can see. I set it to additive, so it's just off the top of the screen at the moment, it's up there. I think I'm going to turn additive off actually. So you can see that wind strength is just going up and down there. And then I added a noise function set to multiply. This is what it does to the previous modifier. I used a scale of 2, a strength of 16, and you can see the wind is going up and down. So you can see we're now getting some variation in the web. Not as much as I had in the other one, but you just need to play around with the values. And the last thing before you turn your geometry nodes back on is make sure your cloth sim is above your geometry nodes. If you put it below, it's going to struggle a lot trying to set the position of all of those particles, whereas they'll happen naturally this way round. And also don't forget to make sure that in your cloth sim, under cache, the endpoint is the same as the animation that you want to create. Turn our geometry nodes back on now. There they are. I can go to my camera and turn on depth of field again. And although it'll struggle a little bit, you can see that we've got some movement now in here. If you select your droplet, by the way, make sure that the glass shader seems to work fine anyway, but just out of good habit, I always set this to alpha hash for the blend and shadow mode. But you can see there's all our little droplets. So I hope you found that interesting. If you did, let me know. I'll upload the original file for use by my Patreons. And if you enjoyed that tutorial, don't forget to click like and subscribe. It does help me. And I will see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.